Namaste. Welcome to shailaji.com. Today we will be doing the next rows of consonants. So without wasting our time, let us get started. Now you can see here we are doing the third row. Ta, tha, da, dha, na. Now I have already told in my third video where this pronunciation is, from where it starts in the mouth. So this is the tongue rolls. And the tip touches on the top of your mouth. So, ta, tha, da, dha, na. So, this is na. And you'll be wondering what these two letters are. Now, these two letters and these two letters, there is no much difference. This, you could see here, there is no dot down, but here these two have got dot. Sound-wise, if you see, there is not much of difference. Now, here, these two letters, you will use it at the beginning of a word. For example, you might not be knowing all the Hindi letters, but then I will just give you an example. For example, I'm writing, it is dagara. It is actually dagar. Now here, you're not going to put a dot. But if you see, and the next one, this one, dholaka, dholak, you don't have a dot. Now here if you see, you put a dot, paid, paid. And the next one, you put a dot, pad, pad. Now these two, if you think you need a difference, there will be like, this is coming at the beginning, so you say da. But that one, as it is coming after, you say da, 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 that kind of sound. Da and da, da, da. So that da, da, that kind of sound will come. That much is the difference. But otherwise, you don't have much difference in both those dot and without dot letters. Before going to the next row, I thought I will tell you about this letter. I would be helping out the Tamil viewers. Now this letter, if you see in Tamil, it is this letter. Okay, so wherever you use this letter, you can use it here. One more thing is, this letter never comes at the beginning of any word. It will always come after any consonant or a vowel or whatever, but not at the beginning of any word. So that you have to remember. Now let me start the writing part of these letters. First put a stroke and then like this and then a line. The next one, same way, you put a stroke, you take it this way round and then you put it, finally you put the line on top. Now this one, if you see, just put like this. You would have written E matra, no? The vowel E. Same way, you have to go and put this way. So, as it is already, you have learned. Now you have learned the first row of the consonants. Vowels you have learned. So, I am not going into deep teaching of that letter. The next one. The next letter, na. See here also, if you see, half, till half this has come and this line has extended from this place to this place. So that is how you write the letters. Now I think you have understood the ta row, or the ta varg we say. Ta row you have understood. So now we will go to the next row. Now let us start the fourth row of the consonants. Now this is, I have told you before where it is sounding, where in my third video you would have followed it. Now again I'll tell you one more time, this will start from like the tongue will come in between the teeth, like ta, tha, da, dha, na, ta, tha, da, dha, na. So ta, tha, da, dha, na, you say dhanalakshmi, dha, dhanalakshmi, dhanam. So this is the dha. Now, how to write it? You see here, now some people will write it like this, not necessary, or you can just put like this and this, that way also you can write, two ways you can write. Now this is the, now see this one, like this you have to bring. And then like this. Always remember, this round should be there. This one. Okay. This round should be there. And when this round comes, the line will not come fully there. So always remember the letters which are having this. More detail I'll tell you later. Now just like ta, you put like that. Then you bring like this. Just like ta. And then down. So you have to bring it down, then only it is the. Now the next one, you curve like this and bring like an ulta three. See here, it goes up and then down. Yes. So this is the. You see this also has a curve, this also has a curve. So the line will not come fully, it will come only there. The next one is, just like a, see, it is just this way. You have to put one line again. And then you have to put this. So very easy and simple way. Now this one again for, what is this in Tamil? Yes. Now this always comes in the, I mean it comes either in the starting of the word, middle, anywhere. It comes, this is na. So the th, the dh, na. Now we have come to the fifth row. In this fifth row, I have told you the sound where these letters sound. So when you join your lips, the sound comes from there. That is pa bha ba bha ma. Pa bha ba bha ma. I've heard many people pronouncing this as fa. No. This is pa, phal, phool. This is pa. If you say that as fa, you should have a dot here. Only then it is fa. Without dot, it will be always pa. Now, I will teach you how to write this. First, you go this way. Next one, you put a line, then again, you bring like this. That is, you just cut it, like swastik, no, you just cut there. And then finally, you draw a line on top. There's another way to write, just like pa, you bring it up, then you go up and do this. People write that way also, in just one stroke. The next letter is ba. So this is ba. Always remember, this letter should be always this side. Some people I've seen, they will write this way, it's wrong. So remember, the letter should always, this cross should come only this side. The next letter is bha. See here again, you have a round, it is not touching. And the last letter of this row, it is very easy, just like this, but be clear in this. If you put a circle and you put a line also, it will become like bha. So be careful when you're writing, this will not have a curve. This will have a curve. And this is ma. So simple, you have learnt how to write, how to pronounce, and what are all these sounds in English also I have given. Pa, pha, ba, bha, ma. So it is so simple to learn. Don't you think it is just 3 minutes is enough for you to remember all these letters, the three rows. So friends, I think you have understood what I have taught here. More and more practice is definitely required to improve your Hindi. And if you have understood this video and you liked it, please like it, share it and subscribe. And you have a small bell icon there. So you click on that, you will get my notifications regularly. One more thing, you have the description box. In that description box, I give some information about the lesson which I'm doing for that day. You can go through that also. And definitely, and one more thing, I'm very happy to tell you all, without your support, I don't think I would have reached to this level. Just I have put 4 videos and you have given me good support by making it to 200 subscribers. Thank you so much, all my viewers, and your support will definitely help me to improve your Hindi more and more and to make more and more videos. Thank you so much. Meet you in the next video. Have a nice day. Namaste.